They used to say the condors would swoop down in villages, grab little children that were bad all year, fly off of them, and then, of course, eat them alive. And
here it comes.
That is just a myth. Condor's feet aren't very strong, so when he's going to eat, he has to eat it where he finds it. Besides the fact that the condors, they do prefer eating dead animals. Because of that, they're considered part of the vulture family. Although they are one of the only vultures in the world, they will sometimes kill and they need their food. Now that he's a bit closer to everyone, you guys might notice that mohawk-looking thing at the very top of his head. That is called a caruncle, and that is a male characteristic. That's actually one of the few ways you can tell the difference between a male and a female, besides the fact that males like Hefe are usually a bit larger than females. We're actually very lucky to have an Andean condor to show. There aren't very many of these guys left in the wild, and his cousin, the California condor, is nearly extinct in the wild, but it's just now making a comeback. So let's give him a big round of applause for Tim Hefe, the Andean condor. Now guys, we've been very fortunate to share with you some of the rare and exotic birds in the state here today.